Dear viewers, welcome to the seminal moment, the official arrival of men onto one of nine with their own slot. O Catholic, where art thou?
What's the matter with me? I don't have much to say.
As often as I can, I'll be getting Catholic men down to the river to pray upon their worldviews. My guests don't have to have all the answers, just be honest and speak for themselves. If we get it wrong, I'm sure you, the dear viewer, will be there to humbly put us right.
Sit down on this bank of sand and watch the river flow. Wish I was back in the city instead of this old bank of sand, with the sun beating down over the chimney tops.
What we want from this watery endeavour is to get some much-needed, robust Catholic male voices back into the public square.
I was expecting it to be a bit more choppy because of the wind.
Incredibly.
Well, that's eerie.
Mark, let's glide for a bit and we'll do a quick intro. Right, this is Mark. He is a guy from my parish. One of many guys in our parish. And you're a convert, Mark.
Yes, I'm a convert.
Married?
Married, yes.
A recent convert?
I'd say, yeah, just over a year. I think the first time I actually went to a Catholic church for Mass was just about a year ago. Yeah, it was just before Christmas.
And married for how long?
In the biblical sense, probably 12 years.
It's great that you
But in the, well, in the law sense, two years. But in the Catholic Church, I'm going the wrong way here, aren't I? But in the Catholic Church, I'm still not married.
You're still not married?
No, 28th of January.
Very interesting.
28th of January, we've got the date for that.
He's an interesting guy.
Certainly going to Bedford, it's an incredible experience. Absolutely different.
Bedford, for the dear viewer, is our local parish.
Yeah, well, I mean, this is a Tridentine Mass. Yeah. It's completely different to Novus Ordo.
Yeah.
Novus Ordo Mass, I remember the first time I went to the Novus Ordo Mass, you kind of get pounced on by all the ladies. Yeah, they all want to talk to you. None of the men are even interested in chatting. Yeah, and it's my experience I've been to quite a few churches, but yeah, the Tridentine one, yeah, the guys will want to chat to you about guy things. It's great. It's brilliant. My wife got me a nice book, actually. It's called Lex Orandi for Christmas. It does a comparison between Novus Ordo Mass and the Tridentine Mass. Oh, I probably shouldn't have read it.
So you can say all this, you're coming to it as a convert. There's no long years of systematic decline in your experience.
Yeah? No.
Just stepping right. You're fresh off the conveyor belt of popular culture, would you say? Would you be like popular culture guy?
Yes, certainly. Certainly since I stopped going to church 30-odd years ago, Methodist.
Instead of religion, would you have signed up to the environment and other justice?
Well, I did. I was vegan for like 5 years.
Yeah.
Did go to a few kind of rallies and things. So, yeah, I've always kind of been kind of activist. There's always kind of been something missing there, I suppose. And I wanted to do something a bit larger than myself. It was all kind of empty, really.
And did you feel that at the time?
Yeah. I mean, you get a kick out doing it because, well, you are doing good. Animal rights and stuff, that's a good thing.
So the good feeling wasn't quite enough?
No, it's not what was my reasoning behind doing it? Am I doing it for the right reasons? Yeah.
Oh, to meet a nice girl or something?
Well, no, I was with Valentina.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah. I mean, I've only been recently back onto eating meat again. That was because I got COVID and, yeah, I couldn't stand the look of vegan, like, meats.
So it wasn't for biblical reasons or anything like that?
No. No, not really, but yeah, I think, well, yes, I started eating meat again and then, yeah, I think I kind of, that's when I started going to the church and inquiring, because we moved. I think what stopped me from actually inquiring about
meat predates going back to church.
Yeah.
Oh, right. So go on.
My movement into the Catholic Church, not really, because I had my rosary and I'm praying my rosary every day for 6 months before I'd even gone to church. But the thing that delayed me was we were saving up for a house. I thought, well, I don't want to go to this parish and go through all the RCIA stuff and then move, because that would be a pain. So no, I came to Biggleswade and then I did it then. And they were surprisingly quick and helpful to start with.
What was the inciting moment or person that got you off pop culture man to Catholic man?
So the moment that it happened is going to be, well, my son being born, we stopped watching TV. That was it. The TV. It was the TV.
No way.
Why did you stop watching TV? 30 days without TV. Stop watching TV. Why? 30 days without TV. Well, we'd watch it. My son would be there, but I just noticed him one day, he's staring up at the TV, mouth open. I mean, he's only, what, 3 months, 4 months at the time? I thought, no, can't have this. So we stopped watching TV for about...
Say that. Why would you say I'm not having this? Why don't we just accept it? TV's part of life. He's got to get used to it.
Because it just looked mindless. And plus, I did some more research into that, and it's like, well, yeah, it is bad for you. Little kids shouldn't have screen time at all. And then you think, well, if it's bad for little kids, why is it good for adults?
Was your wife saying the same thing, or was it, this is you saying it first?
I was saying it first, yeah. Yeah, I led the whole thing. Yeah.
Shut up. So from no TV... You noticed the change in you then?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I wasn't like instantly into religion, but it was completely anti-degeneracy, anything like that. No, I couldn't stand it.
So you went from going to having enjoying it to low tolerance to hating it.
I was the most liberal person you could meet. My favorite TV show was RuPaul's Drag Race.
Ever heard of it? The transgender guy?
Yeah, well. Drag queen, I guess, a famous one, yeah, and they have drag queens come on. And,
was your favourite part.
That was my favourite show, yeah.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. I mean, when I was younger, I was quite conservative, but then, I don't know, something over the years, too much TV maybe, Netflix, there we go, Netflix probably. Netflix maybe that could have done it. But yeah. No more Netflix. I mean, they had that cutie show on and I cancelled my Netflix after that.
Quite a few converts in our parish. You're not alone in that respect. And quite a few converts, early 30s, is that fair to say? Kind of late 20s, 30s, making the jump out of...
Oh, I was late 30s. Sorry, I didn't notice that.
The thing I noticed we don't really have at our church, and other kind of TLM churches, is a lot of single males that are in the 20s. It's not that we've got none, but... A whole load. It's a lot of families, a lot of children, a lot of good signs of life. But
that's true.
Do you think it's hard? Would you say it's harder to get out of the game in your 20s, out of the pop culture game?
Yeah, you've constantly got the stimulus everywhere. I was having a conversation with my friend yesterday when we were out on the hike about
not well, religious friend.
No, I'm trying to get him that way. He's interested. When I talk about the Latin Mass, he's very interested in that. We both read kind of Warhammer 40k books, so it's quite Latin in that sense.
Warhammer 40k, I think, is just copied and pasted.
It's incredibly Catholic. Certainly.
The ruinous powers of chaos.
Yeah, exactly. We have these conversations or arguments, and I think this time, because I mentioned porn and how it's bad and it does something to your brain, and... that's not particularly good. And I think it does the same things, don't quote me on this, it does the same things as seeing acts of violence as well. Or gore.
Yeah,
kind of thing. And he actually, this time round, he kind of talked himself into, maybe it's bad for some people. So, sure.
What would his normal line be? Nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it.
Sharks.
There's absolutely nothing.
Isn't it just obvious that there is something obviously wrong with it, I would say?
Yeah.
So even if you're... not into God, not into anything. You're just not. There's not. It's like a free money tree. It just doesn't exist.
Yeah.
You know, free naked women. It's not real.
No.
You've got to go out there and get your own woman and do your own meeting and do your own dating. And
yeah. And I'm saying that you know, obviously people do need the satisfaction. But I'm saying that there is so much stimulus everywhere that, well. Yeah, they need the satisfaction, but if you remove the stimulus, then perhaps they don't. You know, I was saying that maybe back in the old days, Victorian, you know, when a guy was chatting to a woman, he's not thinking...
Getting laid.
Yeah.
Maybe he is. Well, look, maybe he is, but I kind of think with all of that, I think it's one of the chats, one of the moms.
Well, I think that he's maybe thinking a few more steps instead of like, well, all I need to do is buy her a few drinks and get her back home.
Yeah.
Where he's thinking, I need to buy her... her father a new cow and etc. And then after a year of courting, then we can get married and so forth.
And then you get the gold. There's a proverbial mountain to climb, I think. And I think that's part of the male experience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Anything that comes too easy like that, bad times. And you pay. I think you pay. Not even just spiritually or in a religious sense or right and wrong, but you just pay you desensitized and all that kind of stuff. Look, the kind of date is now really in our favor, I think, for Catholics.
I think so, yeah. I think.
But it's a hard, it's still a tough sell to say, look, monogamy is the best thing for you. Going out there and meeting for someone for real, it's quite hard to do still.
Well, it's like, you know, because I'll get my friend, and little by little, I think maybe he does. By the end of, you know, when I see him, certainly, he'll come round to my way of thinking. But then he'll go home, he'll watch TV, he'll watch his porn. He'll completely forget everything I think.
So on that, I would say all of that's pretty true, and you can kind of, the Catholic can say, well, I've tried, and it's grace that changes. I kind of, it was a seminal moment for me when I kind of, I don't know who said it or where I read it, if I read it, probably heard it. It's grace that changes minds or changes hearts. And we should still do our bit, like have the chat and present the argument, but don't worry if they don't change the mind or they do change the mind. It ain't you anyway.
Yeah, but I think...
We still want to do our bit. We want to.
Yeah, you have to do your bit.
We've got to do our best by natural means and then supernatural. Because it's a supernatural conversion, really, as much as just presenting facts and arguments, even if they are in our favour.
Yeah. And, if there is... If you can get through some of them, like, just say, stop watching TV for a little bit. Yeah, that's how they get
Give it to them straight.
Yeah. The devil's on the TV. It's coming through the TV. For me, anyway. Yeah, that's my trigger. Slightly different now. You know, I come out of confession and... You know, straight away, I've got something in my ear. Do this.
I always think it tries to get you straight after confession. Because then you're not in that such a great state of grace then. You're in a kind of, you've already muddied yourself, if you like.
Yeah.
The next 48 hours are the big ones. After confession.
Yeah, after confession. I know.
I think I'll find the more men are getting here, having a chat, is that the Catholic life is not a kind of beta male experience. It is an alpha male experience. Mm-hmm. And it's really the internal fight, isn't it?
Yeah.
Didn't that great philosopher, what's his, Kanye West? The battle's in us. I forget what the phrase in the song is.
That's the thing. They'll come back, the masters of the TV, they'll come back. And one of my friends were telling me about this Andrew Tate guy. I think he's quite feminine, if I'm saying anything. But people look at him as an alpha male.
Yeah,
it's all about objects and things and buying more. And it's like, well, yeah, that's what my wife's like. Not about, you raise a family and
go without
cutwood. Yeah. Self-mortification,
sacrifice.
Nothing to do with sacrifice.
Because he is a welcome, he's a welcome message from like what generally males have been served up, like Hugh Grant and apologising and all this kind of, I don't even know what you call it, kind of floppy male that came out of the 90s. And and then went on from there and got worse. So it's a refreshing change from all that, but it's not going to get you through the pearly gates by any stretch of the imagination.
No.
He's not the only one out there kind of doing this new...
No, he's not. He's not.
The indictment is on us, not being out there in the public square, putting the real, what we would call the real argument out there. Maybe a man looks at religion and thinks, right, one woman, it's just, I just can't do it. And it's all right, fair enough, you see that argument, because... You want all the fruits in the garden, don't you? You want to try?
You're being offered them all.
Yeah, you've been offered them all, and
it's rude to say no. Because I think a lot of the time there's that idea that, well, you know, don't look a gift horse in the mouth. You know, wonder if you know it's being served up to you right now, you'll regret it.
Get it in your youth.
Yeah,
this kind of thing.
No, I'm traumatized by a lot of things that I've done in the past. Yeah, I do. I'll have flashbacks about some things. Yeah.
Reprehensible.
Yeah. I mean,
keep me in check till I die, quite honestly. I don't know about anyone else, and I wouldn't say to anyone else what their situation is, but for me.
Yeah. Shucks. When I look at things as, well, this isn't my body, this is owned by him upstairs. Exactly. I'm just kind of renting it for now. Yeah. And I've got to keep it in good shape. When it gets returned, then he's going to decide.
And you judged on it, which are kind of part of the problem. Exactly. I want to start each of these, well, I'll start it now. For the Catholic man, you know, we are judged. And when you die, there's a final judgment, and the kind of the zeitgeist is, look, everyone's going to be all right, everyone's going to make it. But I think for us as TLMers, did I throw an umbrella in? I hope I did.
There was an umbrella.
I think it's down it. Yeah, the zeitgeist is, everyone's going to make it, everyone's going to be all
right. Yeah, everyone gets saved. That's very positive. Yeah.
And I think even for the most...
You've got to have faith.
You just got to have faith. Oh, I've done something warm and fuzzy in your life, and that'll be enough. I just don't think that is how it's going to be at all.
No. You read the Bible.
You don't get any indication of that.
No, not at all.
Not at all.
Not at all.
No one, even the kind of more warm and fuzzy saints, do not give you any indication that that is the case. And why? And then I think justice is such a thing that runs deep, even for the person who doesn't believe in God. Yes, do people want justice? Mm-hmm. But if you want justice for others, I've heard Peter Hitchens say this, a great phrase, you've got to expect it for yourself. Mm-hmm. What standard are you going to be judged by? Right, look, it's going to be a Christian one.
If I can, so nice on here.
Can I see that? You've got a nasty cut on your knee there. You've got a nasty...
Oh, yeah, I went for a run on Monday, I think it was. It was very slippery. There was a lot of leaves. There's an old run I used to like doing in Harpenden. It's an old abandoned railway. I thought, I'm gonna go and do this full 16 miles. That didn't happen. I managed to get 3 miles and slipped over, and my knee was just completely gashed open.
Running appeals to people with a certain drive, Mark. Were you a runner before you were religious?
Yeah.
Some of the guys in our parish have got a bit of drive in them, and I half wonder, is it that kind of drive that kind of gets them round to religion?
I think
it's not an ambivalent act, is it? It's kind of...
Yeah, I mean... Just thinking, you know, I suppose there's a kind of a guarantee. If you exercise, you're going to definitely get something out of it. You're going to get fitter. And I suppose if you pray, it's going to help you spiritually. You don't necessarily get what you want. You get what you need.
I tell you, as soon as I stop, I see the descent. Like, it's a straight line of...
Yeah, I mean...
I will descend.
Yeah. I think that's what keeps me straight and narrow. Rosary every day, Angelus 3 times a day, and then an examen.
That's probably my staple diet, actually. I'm a big Angelus guy. What about your wife? So she's religious as well? Or not?
She's cradle Catholic. She's not particularly religious.
So she's coming along this ride with you?
Yeah.
Well, what have we got? Let's get the coffee out, Mark. Coffee or beer? Coffee, come on. Come
on, coffee as well. Coffee would be great. I used to take it in my tea. Now, yeah. I think if you have milk with it, maybe, yeah. I'm always thinking, I wonder what things are going to be like in 10 years.
Regards what? Faith or surviving?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things is, certainly at our church...
Cultural view.
In 10 years, certainly in our church, when all the kids have grown up, I wonder what that's going to be like.
Yeah.
Because apparently, I think this is a Pew Research, that it was, I think, it was something ridiculously low, about... 20%, I may be getting this wrong, but it's something very low of Catholics. 20% of kid cradle Catholics will leave the church. That's Novus Ordo. And I think it's 20% stay, and then 97% of the Latin community, they'll stay.
Our numbers aren't going to suddenly mushroom by any stretch of the imagination.
No, I don't think so. The Synod on Synodality is kind of showing that people are happy.
I hesitate to use the miracle, but it is a miracle of what we've got at Bedford. Family upon family, guys there, people chatting after. You wouldn't be lost for male company after Mass. It's not like the only two males would be that are serious about Jesus are bound to chat. You're sport for choice almost, like for solid dudes.
Yeah, I've got good friends now, so that's great.
It's mad, isn't it?
Thank you.
You may not want cream.
All the tiny little things that push me towards the church. But yeah, it is a different story because these things just pop into my head.
Do you think it was long in the making?
Yeah. I mean, even before I turned off the TV, I think. No, it wasn't. It was just after I turned off the TV. It was getting that picture of the Annunciation, which kind of pushed me.
What picture?
The Annunciation.
You got it off the
TV? My mother got me a painting of the Annunciation.
What do your parents make of your switch?
I don't know what my dad thinks. He kind of... I think it was my dad that pushed me to Catholicism. So thanks, Dad, for passing away. It was after my dad passed away, the nurse had asked if I wanted, there was a priest available, and if I wanted to give him the last rites. And like, something just said to me in my head, sure. And this was after I'd got the painting as well, after stopping watching the TV. Something just said, sure. Because I was looking for a religion, one that was going to fit. And then the next day, went online, bought a rosary. That's kind of when it... sort of really kicked off as far as Catholicism.
The rosary is quite a heavyweight prayer to get into before you're even going to Mass.
Yeah, but I wanted to get started straight away.
And did your dad get the last rites?
Brilliant. Yeah, my mother had to, she didn't want to hang around because my dad's getting palliative care in the hospital.
Great gift for your dad.
Yeah, I think so.
From his son.
Yeah, so hopefully.
So you're doing some real heavyweight stuff before you get to church, before you get down the aisle with God.
Yeah, something just guided me. You know, there was a little voice. And it wasn't that horrible little voice that said, you know, that feels good, do that. Mm. No one's going to know if, you know, if it goes wrong, do that, do that. No, it was like, do this. You know, it's the right thing to do. Actually, it wasn't really even that, it was just do this. And then it just...
You did it.
It was just a feeling.
It was defying you to not do it.
Yeah, yeah. I couldn't think of not doing it, you know. It was just like that. It was like, okay, yeah, yeah, we'll have the last rites. It's like, right, okay, that's it. Yeah, I'm definitely Catholic. There's nothing else. I don't think God gives you something you can't get over. Some people may get things that seem a lot worse. You know, their whole family gets murdered and they're left crippled. But maybe they have the faculties within themselves to get over it if they really want to. Maybe some people wouldn't be able to get over that. So God's not going to come in.
It's the Lord.
Yeah, I recently read a psalm, and I can't remember which psalm it was about that. But yeah, he was complaining that there's a group of people that, you know, they get everything. You know, they go out, they have loads of money, they spend it all, but you know, and it's upsetting. But you know, he's got God. I can't remember which one what it is now. Maybe Psalm 83.
Well, next time we get you on here, you'll know it.
Oh yeah, I know. I'm terrible at this.
You're a good reader.
Yeah, I read a lot, but yes, you're not getting the chapter and verse. I know it's there, and I know.
I think it's a natural talent.
Generally, with books, I'll get the books.
No. So you wide over. I certainly wouldn't want to put anyone that's not on the boat into the picture without their permission. But you're married, your wife's not on board with it.
Oh, she's on board. She's on board.
Oh, great.
With, yeah, I mean, we're raising our son. So, yeah, she's kind of happy with that. I think she's, well... The best route is Catholicism. He's protected. He's got a good community. You know, if things go really downhill, then well, we'll save up a few quid and see what we can get. Get him into St. Michael's.
SSPX.
We went to a school. It was a upper school, high school, in Biggleswade. Yeah, and we're walking out, and she's like, "Look at this poster. All LGBT stuff about yeah." Love is love thing.
Yeah.
Like, okay, one poster, that's a bit weird. But then you turn around, and once you've seen one, there was loads, they're everywhere. Like, okay, sure. But, you know, and that's one of the things. But yeah, apparently, as far as kind of relationship education goes, they really don't have to teach very much. So it's usually the teachers and the headmasters that are just going above and beyond the call of duty with this stuff. So, yeah, that's a bit scary.
Yeah, it is scary, even from 5 years ago. Even since Regina Celli started, that's the kind of school associated with the parish.
It's
become frightening. And I must say, it's not just the TLM thing, the Regina Celli, it's all kinds. It's true diversity, mm-hmm. Mark. Yeah, we're reclaiming the word for ourselves.
Yeah, there's just so many activists in the schools. It's not particularly mandated. Going above and beyond the call of duty.
Yeah, with enthusiasm, with real enthusiasm.
Yeah. Sometimes you just make the mistake and you think, well, you know what? It just makes sense to me. Why don't other people see this? Because maybe they're being propagandized. Like I said, my friend, I'll speak to him, he'll see my point of view. It all makes sense to him. Yeah. Next week, it's as if I've never talked to him about it at all. I'll keep plugging away. He says he watches less TV now.
So, great.
Okay. He doesn't watch as much porn anymore.
What would your view on contraception have been beforehand and all those kind of things?
Yeah,
we
used all that.
Which are worldly tenets now. Mm.
Yeah, I did support it. I don't support it at all. I think it's probably left Western countries in a bit of a predicament. I mean, certainly the pill, contraceptive pill. Valentina never had any of that. But yeah, I've heard some stories about kind of hormones getting into the water supply. It might explain feminized men.
Right, yeah. Go some way. So you didn't need oh, I need to listen to another talk, I need more convincing, I can't let go of my worldly views. You don't seem like that was the case.
No, I completely give it all up. You know, the Catholic Church has 1,700 years of experience.
You didn't say some kind of like, well, there's modern technology like the pill and that changes everything and the previous world before that is totally different.
Actually, you know what probably changed my opinion on that? Probably Ted Kaczynski, the Unabomber. I read his manifesto, Industrial Society and Its Future. And that's when I kind of realised that, yeah, technology is not necessarily a good thing.
You've only been in the past a year, no less.
It would have been Christmas Day was my first.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, that was the first time. After.
What got you to Bedford?
Dr. Taylor Marshall, I think.
All right.
Yeah. Because I was just looking up Latin masses.
Yeah.
After watching Taylor Marshall. And Bedford came up. I needed to go somewhere on Christmas Day. But you had to pre-book the Novus Ordo ones.
Like, lots of that.
Yeah. And they're like, oh no, sorry, we're fully booked. Maybe go try going to Bulldog. Yeah, I've been to Bulldog.
No thanks.
That place is empty. I remember going in there. First time I went in there, I had my mask on. Going, I looked around like, right. Well, I'm not wearing that.
I mean, I can't feel with the parish. There's no. Some people do wear the mask. I don't think anyone cares what particularly anyone does. There's no. Yeah. Like, even after mask, you know, trads get a bit of reputation. They've all got it in for the mobile.
Yeah.
Kind of chat.
It's just... No, that's not at all. There's like those YouTube channels. You'll have Taylor Marshall and Return to Tradition, those kind of people. And
concert. It gets
all
old.
It does. I'm so tired. Yeah, come on, just say something positive, honestly.
I just sit here and watch the river flow. Watch the river flow. Watching the river flow.
Mark, I'm going to wrap it up. Mark, thanks very much. I hope we get you on again and put this camera away so we can give it some well.
I think I've got a lot more to say.
Yeah.
No, I'm happy to. It's really, really good. It's cathartic.
River flow.